DODI releases.
Scientist log number 117. Just wanting to provide a quick update as we descend towards the Red Arc facility. I have to admit, as we get closer to Mars, the excitement is really hitting home. I've barely slept, although how much of that is due to conditions on the ship, I'm unsure. I guess I shouldn't complain. The funding this mission's received should allow for more than pleasant sleep.
Trying to fasten your seatbelts. Landing in 5 minutes.
Okay, that's looking like we'll have to go now. Keep an eye out for more mission updates as we go on. Signing out. Scientist log, number 125. But please forgive my momentary loss of words, but I am somewhat overwhelmed with excitement. As I speak now, I am taking my first steps into the Martian cave where the plants were first discovered. And, wow, believe me, this place is magnificent. Plants, breathable air. All of this shouldn't make sense, being on Mars. So now onto the task of finding its life source. It's water. Human Trials number 47. Today, I'm here with our head of security on this facility, Mr. Conroy.
Hello, Doctor. This test isn't going to be difficult, is it?
No, super easy. Barely an inconvenience. All you have to do is take a swig of this water, and we'll monitor you for a couple of hours, and we'll see how you feel.
No problem. Tastes tinny, but fresh at the same time.
Interesting.
Tell me, Doc, your test found anything interesting?
No, nothing out of the ordinary. I think everything's going rather well.
Thank you. 3 more cards and the suit, and then I can get back to my ship. Ah, this place is like a fucking maze. Three more cards and the suit, and then I can get back to my ship. Ah, this place is like a fucking maze. Take a seat, Doctor.
Is there a problem? Why exactly have you brought me here, Mr. Conroy?
Everyone who has drank the water has either died or fallen ill. Everybody except for me and you.
How curious. You must have developed an immunity to the bacteria in the water. I haven't drank any myself.
What do you mean you haven't drank any yourself?
Well, a good doctor never tests on themselves. Do they, Mr. Conroy?